similarities between Chuck Liddell and Conor McGregor. Honestly, after seeing this fight, I'm seeing a lot of more similarities in Conor McGregor and Chuck Liddell on the fact that both these guys are counterfighters. Both these guys were on a tremendous winning streak. Both these guys were superstars. Both these guys like to fight with their hands low. Both these guys knock guys out. But what's going on with Conor McGregor now and his future in the UFC? Because we've seen before in the past with Chuck Liddell, he seemed like he was unbeatable. Randy Couture was able to take him down and get a TKO on him. He came back. He was able to beat Randy Couture. Also, another person that was able to beat Chuck Liddell was Rampage Jackson. Rampage Jackson was able to take him down and beat him on the ground. Again, this is more information for the opponents to know about Chuck Liddell. People are, every time you're on the top, the people on the bottom are studying everything, all your weaknesses and all your strengths. So we've seen that happen. Then, whatever, Chuck came back to the UFC, did his thing. Then Rampage got signed by the UFC once that the UFC bought Pride. So what happened? Rampage came back and he was able to finish Chuck Liddell on its feet. So after that, we seen Chuck Liddell come back, fight Wanderlei, win. And then after that, it was just going downhill. After that, he got knocked out by Rich Franklin. He got knocked out by Shogun Rua. He got knocked out by Rashad Evans. He lost a split decision by Keith Jardine. He lost and he lost by Tito Ortiz in the third fight. So what's going on with this? I think it has to do a lot with time, of course. Chuck Liddell wasn't the same Chuck Liddell he was before, but also what you gotta take in consideration is that when you fight so much and you are the champion, a lot of people are realizing everything that you're good at and everything that you're bad at. So the more fights you have, the more content is out of people to study you, more information is out. Unlike Khabib, yes, he had a lot of fights in the UFC, but a lot of people weren't able to go to his old fights and to really figure him out. They had to use all the information that they have of certain fights to be able to know about Khabib, which that's why it makes it more difficult to be a champion so long in the UFC, because the more times you defend your belts, the fights get harder and people start realizing what are your techniques. So, yes, Conor McGregor and Chuck Liddell do have a lot in common. Both of them like to counter-strike. Both of them like to keep their hands low. The only difference is that Chuck Liddell is an orthodox fighter and McGregor is a southpaw fighter. But what are we seeing? We're seeing right now that something similar is happening to Conor McGregor. He's fighting a lot more, so there's a lot more weaknesses showing in his fight game. We've seen that his takedown defense is good, but it wasn't really that good when he fought Dustin Poirier. So Dustin Poirier took him down automatically, leaving Conor McGregor to think about what? The takedowns. So when you leave him worrying about the takedowns, that's when you can start striking. You fake low, go high. He was able to knock out McGregor. How do you do that? Again, you start hard on him. Also, the leg kicks. The leg kicks was a significant strike that a lot of people could not use against Conor McGregor. The outside calf kick, on the fact that Conor McGregor faces a lot of, what? Orthodox fighters. So when you fight an orthodox fighter and you're a southpaw, you're more wide. So so when you put a person that's southpaw just like you, that calf kick is open all day. And we already seen McGregor in his past having problems with that calf kick when he fought Nate Diaz. And now with Dustin Poirier, what is happening? We're seeing a pattern that's going on with Conor McGregor. He's releasing content. We're realizing his strengths and his weaknesses. And all his opponents and future opponents are realizing this. So they're going to start attacking that leg a lot more on Conor McGregor because he does have a wide stance. They'll probably even switch stance in southpaw because they see that Conor McGregor has a problem with fighting a person that has the same southpaw position as him, leaving him open for that leg. Also, being able to come in the pocket with the person that has the same stance as you. But again, it goes back to the similarities with him and Chuck Liddell. It's all about content. And when you finish people the same way that you've been finishing them your whole career, which is normally knockout or TKO, now they already more or less know what to expect from you. So if they could take you to the ground, they already defused one of your powers, which is your striking. Then once they take you down and put you back up, now your striking is still a little is still diffused minorly, but you still got to worry about those takedowns, and that's when the punches start coming up. So Chuck Liddell was great, Anderson Silva was great, Conor McGregor was great. But like I said, the thing is, when once you get to the UFC and you start fighting more and more and more, you're releasing more content. Pretty much, you're giving people the same poison for them to use on you in the future. So this possibly, I feel like Conor McGregor is going to be very difficult for him to reach that that title once again. On the fact, like what I said, people are already figuring him out. They're already finding weakness. They're finding chinks in his armor. I'm still a fan of Conor McGregor. McGregor still can do big things. But when it comes to fighting the top opponents for a title, I think it's going to be fairly difficult for Conor McGregor to go back to the top like that where he once was.
Like these breakdowns, make sure you look at the other videos that I have. And subscribe now to our MMA420 YouTube channel. Now on Instagram at _MMA420_.